logging in and ready.
I didn't want to start without everyone being on, but again, welcome. This is Ashley Stewart and I am Christina Mendez, and we're going to do modeling questions, Q&A, tips. The question that I get all the time, and sorry, I'm going to be looking everywhere. Again, we're live on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. So how do I become a plus size model? There's really no one way to answer this. Again, there's not one way to answer this, because you can get discovered walking down the street. You can go through an agency. You can become a freelance model. So there's a lot of ways to become a plus size model. And I'm here today to give you some ways to become one. Google, use it. Research. Research is key, ladies. A successful model is a smart model. So you have to be able to research. Google is your friend. I say it all the time. Use it, abuse it, find the information you need. Also, you can seek agency representation. An agency model is someone that's represented by an agency, and the agency has 20% of your checks. So they basically find you gigs, manage you, they teach you stuff, they develop you. The way to find an agency, go on Google or, again, research. Find local agencies in your area that are looking for models and follow the instructions. Following instructions is a key thing, ladies. So go online, look to see if they have open castings, look to see if they are allowing models to submit pictures, and follow the directions on the website. Now, a good tip, any legit agency will not charge you anything. So if they're charging you something, be very suspicious, folks. And again, I'm looking at three cameras here, so bear with my cross-eyed self right now. We're doing Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube Live.
They're saying they love you from South Bend, Indiana.
Hey, Indiana. You can also choose to be a freelance model. A freelance model is a model that is responsible for looking for her own gigs. Sometimes freelance models do work with agencies, but they're just not signed exclusively. So a freelance model is what I am. I've been a freelance model for 92% of my career. So most of my career, I've been a freelance model. I have to look for my own gigs. I have to manage myself. I have to deal with my own bookings and my own financing. It's not the easiest thing, but it is very possible. You can also get discovered on social media. Guys, social media is like, when I started, I had MySpace and Craigslist. You guys have Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, and a whole bunch of other places to get discovered. A tip to get discovered online, be very social and be very active online. So if you have an awesome outfit, I'm wearing an Ashley Stewart bralette, I would totally do a selfie so they can see it, the item. I would hashtag Ashley Stewart, by Ashley Stewart, and I will also tag by Ashley Stewart, which is on their Instagram and Facebook. And you know what? I have worked with girls that Ashley Stewart has discovered online. So don't underestimate the power of social media in a good picture. And don't get discouraged. If they don't re-tag or repost your stuff, they have over 200,000 followers. So don't get discouraged. They'll get to you. Just keep on posting, keep on being awesome, and keep on rocking those outfits that you like. Another way to get discovered is going through networking. Come out to events. We got Full Figure Fashion Week coming up in June. Go out to that event. It is a week full of events, of designers, of agencies, of other models. You get to meet them. You get to socialize with them. And being around like-minded people will get you started, ladies. When you come out to these events, don't forget your business cards. It's very important to... Every conversation you end, you give a business card, and trust me, someone will discover you. Another way is entering contests. If you hashtag and go into Instagram and look at hashtag contests, hashtag modeling contests, hashtag model search, you'll find a bunch of contests. But Ashley Stewart has a contest. It's called Finding Ashley Stewart 2017. This person gets a photo shoot, gets a video session, gets, I think, agency? Gets a whole bunch of stuff, okay? So it is a free contest. Like, why wouldn't you enter? The next stop is actually in Houston, Texas, and after that, they're going to Detroit and New York. Being a model, you gotta travel. So guess what? If you're not from Texas and you're from the surrounding areas, get your butt there. It's like a flight, a ride away, a bus away. get there. You have to be in it to win it, ladies. So next stop, Texas, after that, Jersey, then Detroit.
Question on Instagram. Is modeling enough to pay the bills?
Good question, whoever that was. Good question. Modeling can pay the bills, but it just takes a lot of work. As a model, you have to be consistently trying to find gigs to pay the rent. It's like any freelance job. Sometimes you have a really good month and sometimes you have a really bad month. So you have to even out your income by working super duper hard. But I also recommend, most models have side gigs. Just do different stuff. Some models enjoy makeup, so they'll do makeup on the side. Some models enjoy workshops, like myself, so I do that on the side. So just find your niche and don't rely only on modeling, especially when you just started.
Any advice for aspiring short plus size models?
Petite plus size models are getting work too. So don't get discouraged. There's always an exception to the rules, and I know a bunch of shorter plus size models who are doing it. Being a commercial model, there's no height limit. Where the height limit comes is being a runway model. So if you want to do print and you want to slay, then you're good no matter what size you are. Any other questions on Facebook?
They're coming in slowly, but I'll keep reading them as they come. So make sure to send over your questions so Christina can answer them.
So again, I'm on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. Hey, YouTube. I've never been on YouTube live, so be kind to me. So again, speaking on finding Ashley Stewart 2017, there, if you go on the website, you'll see the full details on the website. So follow that instructions. I think you got to fill out a form first and then submit it. Follow instructions. A tip when you're doing a model search, not because I'm on Ashley Stewart, but I am. If you're going to Ashley Stewart model search, it would be nice to wear something Ashley Stewart. They would actually remember you a little more than you rolling up with something else. So if you're gonna go do a model search, at least buy one item of it. It could be a pair of earrings, it could be a t-shirt. I know times is hard, but we gotta see that you love it. So buy something, anything. Also, when you're prepared, you perform better. So ladies, if you're going to do a model search, I think part of this is your personality and how outgoing you are. So go on the website. I think it gives you the question they're gonna say. So practice the question in the mirror, and also practice your runway. Practice back and forth. If you can't pay for someone to teach you, practice. Practice. When they do a runway contest, they're not requesting for you to do a bunch of stuff. So keep it basic, the front and back. Yes, you can do a turn if you're used to that. If you're not used to taking off your coats or your jacket, don't do that. Don't try new stuff on a contest, ladies, okay? Don't try new shoes and don't try new tricks on the runway. Keep it basic, and that might get you in the door better than you trying to Beyonce your way through things, okay? Any other questions before I move on?
Yes. There's a question. Any advice on finding agencies and modeling coaches?
Agencies are super easy to find. Again, go on Google, go on Plus Model Mag. They have lists of agencies that are reputable plus size agent, or just Google legit model or plus size modeling agencies, and you should get a bunch of places where they give you a full list. So look at the list, go on their website, and see the instructions on if they're hiring new models and what type of models they're looking for. It could be different all the time. They might want dark-skinned girls, light-skinned girls, short girls, size 14, size 18. So again, just keep on looking, keep on checking.
How do you get your foot in the door?
Well, we've been talking about it, but again, there's no right way to answer that. There's a million ways on how to get your foot in the door. What I've been recapping on what I've been saying is, you can go through an agency, you can become a freelance model, which is finding your own gigs, you can get discovered on social media, you can get discovered through networking events, and you can get discovered during model searches and contests that are going on throughout the industry. But again, go to Ashley Stewart's website and go to the Finding Ashley Stewart tag so you can get rules and regulations on that contest coming up.
How many pics should be in a portfolio?
It should be the best that you have. So the reason I say that is it doesn't have to be 20 pages of pictures. It could be 3 pages of 3 amazing pictures versus 20 pages of pictures that are just okay. It's said that when you go to a casting, because time is limited, sometimes they know on the third to second picture if they want to hire you or not. So that's the reason not to have a full book of pictures that are okay, where they're like, oh, I kind of liked her on the first two, and now I'm like, oh, maybe I'm rethinking that. So don't have them rethink it. Stick with your most, your best pictures, and if that's three, let that be three. Any other questions?
Okay. They can keep them coming.
Keep questions coming. Again, I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Model essentials. It's very important for models to have good skin. Yes, makeup can cover a trillion things, but it is important to have good skin so the makeup can lay where it needs to lay. In addition, photoshopping costs a lot of money, and a lot of clients don't want to deal with that. So if modeling is something you want to pursue and your face and your skin is not where you want it to be, start seeking a dermatologist now so you can take care of that situation. There's nothing a dermatologist can't fix, maybe. So again, go check it out. Stop dealing with the over-the-counter situations. If it's ongoing, maybe it's something else, okay? So again, go to a dermatologist. Good hair is very important. Yes, weaves, we love wigs, but good hair is important. Healthy hair is important. Not every client is gonna want a wig from you. They might want you in a ponytail, and if you have nothing to work with, it's a very difficult situation. So take care of your hair, ladies. Do protective styles if that's what you're into. Natural hair is in now. Take care of that as well. Another thing is clean nails and toes. Juliana, who's here, is like, praises me for that. She wants clean nails and toes. It's very important. Just keep them clean. I have a couple of tricks for you. You come to my website, I can tell you a couple of tricks. But clean nails, clean toes, no designs. Actually, in modeling, acrylics and design is not a thing for us. So the less, the better. We do nudes, we do pinkish, we do French manicures, but clean is better than red, it's better than glitter, and it's definitely better than rhinestones. So stay away from that, ladies. Also, awesome pictures. Awesome pictures is important. It's important to get a good photographer. There's a bunch of places, again, where you can get a list of photographers. I do Instagram modeling live on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and I give good information, so come to my Instagram page so you can get information on photographers that I recommend. But again, you could go online and you could see a bunch of places, or follow your favorite models, and if you like the picture, say, hey, who shot your picture? And maybe you can hire this person. Good pictures is important. It's like your resume. When you come into a job, you have a paper resume. As a model, you have a picture resume. It shows your the way you can pose. It shows how you look good in camera. Not everyone, there's people that are pretty in person, but take freaking horrible pictures. It's just, some people are just not photogenic. They just want to see how that is, how you transform in front of a camera. Also, good personality. Good personality is key. This is a woman's environment. If you're quiet, if you're reserved, we sometimes think that you're just stuck up. That might not be the issue with you. You just might be shy. You just might be out of your comfort zone. But you have to say it. It's best to say, look, I'm so shy right now, but I'm gonna talk to you. Or I'm so uncomfortable, I think I'm gonna die. I wanna throw up, but I'm talking to you. At least we know that it's not that you're being stuck up. It's that your personality is not outgoing and you're trying. So as a model, you have to have a super outgoing personality, and you have to be able to talk to anybody.
Is there an age limit for modeling?
Good question. I don't think there's an age limit to modeling. It depends on how you treat yourself. There's 20-year-old girls that look like 40-year-old girls, and there's 40-year-old girls that look like 20-year-old girls. So just take care of yourself, drink a lot of water, take care of your skin, and in reality, there's models for everything. There's models that model AP, you know, retirement funds. Those are like 70, 80 models. There's models that model Pampers that are 2 years old. So there's really no limit to modeling. It just depends. It just becomes a different format of modeling.
What is the right rate you should charge when you're starting?
Oh my God, that's a very difficult question. It might not be for this Instagram. That's advanced. This is modeling 101, not modeling, you know, advanced. You're about to graduate. but it's different rates are for different things. I strongly tell people, like, just know your limit. If you're brand new, start your negotiating low. Don't expect to get paid what a model that's been working for years is getting paid. because realistically, this is might be the way you're learning. So just be open-minded and think also that I always mention, not all paid gigs, not all gigs have monetary value. They come with other different values. So starting off, if you get a gig just for experience, don't feel a certain way. It's you're learning, and they're not paying you, but they're gonna teach you an experience that you've never had. So not all gigs have monetary value.
Any advice for people that don't make it in life, for instance, they don't win contests or they can't make it into full figure fashion week, what advice do you have for them?
To keep on trucking. I first started a long time ago. I'm gonna say like 14 years ago maybe. And when I first started, I couldn't get a gig like to save my life. Like I would try out for stuff and I wouldn't get it. And I would try agencies and wouldn't get it. And I'm still here. So we've watched enough American Idols and all those other shows. The winner is not always the one we remember. So don't feel a certain way that you didn't win, because you've been noticed and you're doing something you love. So just take it and just trust the journey, guys. Trust the journey.
They're asking for your social media handle so they can follow you. So
social media is model Christina Mendez. I'm on IG, Facebook, and YouTube. So model Christina Mendez. And you can follow me on www.christinamendez.com, and you can get all my social media handles. And now modeling, another thing, sizes is what I always hear. What are the right sizes for a plus size model? In the fashion industry, it starts at a size 8, ladies. Obviously, you and I know, and we're like, no, she couldn't be, but it does start at a size 8. However, the girls that are working the most now, because that changes, it's like a difference all every time. The girls that are working the most now are size 14, 16, and 18. Ashley Stewart and a bunch of other clients have extended sizes, so size 20, 22s, 24s. You girls are gonna start working your butts off too. So just be comfortable at the size that you are and love yourself at the size that you are, and opportunities will make its way. So don't be like, oh, I'm trying to be a size 16 and killing yourself, because tomorrow they'll be like, no, we're not into 16s anymore. We're gonna be into 18. Then now you're gonna eat your way up. So just be comfortable on the size that you are and confident, and jobs will start coming to you. Any other questions? Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. Keep it coming. Any questions you guys have, just let me know. Height. I'm not the tallest model, but I'm not going to tell you my height because that's my personal situation. But 5'9 is what agencies require. However, there's an exception to every rule. So don't get discouraged if you see that we're looking for a 5'9. Would I tell you to go for it? I would absolutely tell you to go for it and change their mind. So slay harder, wear higher heels, wear heels with platform, but don't ever get discouraged when you see a certain requirement. There's always, you know, exceptions to rules.
What's a good waist trainer, girdle, shapewear that you would recommend?
I have different ones. So I do use Spanx, but I do use fajas, like Colombian fajas, when I want some real powerful stuff. When I want to smooth myself out, I use Spanx. I also use a real supportive pantyhose, and then I cut them. I know that's like my own trick, but I like the way that they feel, because I don't like to be like constrained.
What size are you? By the way, you're gorgeous.
Thank you. I am a size 14, but I'm going up like a 16 lately. Like my hips are going to a different direction. But yes, I'm between a 14, 16 at any given day.
What advice do you have for naysayers?
Prove them wrong. Prove them wrong. I myself, my family was never supportive, and they still barely supportive. I doubt that any of them are on this stuff. But I just use them as my motivator. Like they, and a lot of people, not only family and friends, always doubt. You always find a couple of doubters. So you just gotta work that much harder to prove them.
Someone says, saludos guapa y a toda la gente de Ashley Stewart.
Hey, saludos. Ashley Stewart's al español también.
How can I become a curvy model? I used to be a pageant queen. I'm short, but I know the tricks.
Yeah, hey, that's it. That's all you need. I mean, again, we've been talking about it since we started a couple of minutes ago, but there's a lot of ways to get discovered. You can get discovered on social media. You can get discovered through seeking an agency. You can find your own gigs. You can do modeling contests. So there's a lot of different ways of doing this. And now the new way of technologies, there's so many other ways. Like, I'm just giving you a couple, but I'm sure if you guys use your creative hats, you can get discovered in many, many, many ways. So that's about it. If you guys don't have any questions.
Oh, does tanning smooth out cellulite when wearing certain things?
I love tanning. I think it does. It doesn't smooth it out. I just think the appearance makes it better. And I honestly, I'm all for that. I think that tanning does help. When I'm about to do swimsuits, I will go tan or do something that will make me tan. They sell sprays, and I think they have the same effect to me. So you can do like spray tans as well. You can buy, I don't know if you guys use those, the pantyhose, right? That gives you a tan. If you get a little shade darker than your actual skin, you spray it on and it looks absolutely fabulous.
Tips for walking in tall heels, because of course you're the queen of runway and the queen of everything.
Walking in tall heels, you have to practice. It does not come overnight. It's like everything. You have to practice in them enough to then feel comfortable in them. After you feel comfortable in them, then you'll be like, whatever. And ladies, please, don't get it discouraged. I sometimes walk in some heels and I'm like, this, I feel totally wobbly. I'm gonna bust my butt. It's certain heels. So you gotta practice. There's some heels that don't hold all this body. So practice with different heels until you get the right sturdy heel. How's Facebook going over there?
It's going great. Do you have to model swimsuit to model underwear?
You have to be open to model everything. Swimsuits, lingerie, panties and bras. I've modeled some crazy stuff, but you have to be open. As a plus size model, your market, the people that are buying this, are plus size women. So what you feel self-conscious about, they probably have it. The cellulite, they probably have it. The extra fat on the side, they probably have it. The back fat, they probably have it. So don't feel embarrassed to model that with the market that is plus size. We are totally okay with that. So if that's the reason why you wouldn't want to model it, just know that you're going to be embraced. What we have here?
In the portfolio, should you have all types of pics, bathing suit, jeans, underwear, dresses, etc.?
Again, it should be your best, the best three or best four that you have. But in your portfolio, in your comp card, so for those that don't know, a comp card is just like a resume that you leave at a place of business and you don't get it back. So the comp card would have one picture in the front. That should be a headshot, okay, with a big, smiley, good eye contact. And the one in the back should be at least four pictures. It could be a bathing suit. It could be a full picture. And it can also be like a tear sheet. A tear sheet is something you've done before. So back then, the reason we used to call it tear sheet is because we used to take it from the magazine and tear it out, right? And it would be called a tear sheet. But now, we pretty much all of our stuff is online. So you could just simply put it on your comp card, and it could be a picture that you did from a boutique, from a fashion show, and put it in your comp card. So that'll be four in the back.
So how do you find the perfect jean?
The perfect jeans? Trying them all on. You just gotta keep trying. Everyone has different body shapes. Everyone has different flaws that they're trying to cover or embrace or enhance. So you just gotta keep on trying. I personally like anything with elastic in it. Anything with spandex in it is my friend. I got big hips. So I need something with stretch.
Posing tips.
Posing tips, again, like everything, by practicing. Practice in front of the mirror, practice in front of a camera. However, when you practice in front of the mirror, what you do in front of the mirror and the camera is totally different. So practice in the mirror first, and then you tell your family, your friends, your boyfriend to take a picture of it, and then you'll start evaluating, like, okay, my neck looks crazy there. Okay, my face looks crazy there. Okay, that doesn't work. So the more you practice, the more you'll know your body and what works. Because again, it's not the same for everyone. I can tell you, do this pose, and that might not look good with you. So, practice.
Are tattoos a turn off for some clients?
Yes, they are. If you don't have tattoos, don't get any. And if you have tattoos, stop getting them because you will be required to cover them. People cover them with Dermablend. I personally have no tattoos, so I don't know the covering techniques, but I do see models struggle to get those covered. So yes, stay away from tattoos if you absolutely can.
Hi from Chile.
Hi, Chile.
Shout out to Ty Hunter, Naima Terry, and Frankie Tavares all joined into your live session.
Hey, booze, all my booze.
I know, they're all here. Okay, they're asking more questions about portfolio. Do you want to talk about the portfolio that you have, your iPad and all that?
Yes, so a lot of things have changed since I started modeling. Again, I come from the MySpace era. Don't judge me, embrace me. Okay, so portfolios have changed from the actual 9x12 big scuba books, which is the heavy portfolio books, to actually iPads. So I have an iPad, and that is what I use for my clients. It's super easy. I suggest you, if you have it, to purchase one that's not the one that you give to your kids, not the one that you use, because the worst is to give it to a client and it's like a pop-up reminder of some craziness in your life. Okay, so use one that you only use for modeling, and you pretty much just do a folder with your pictures, and you can switch that around depending on the client, and it's easier. You don't have to print it out. You don't have to deal with it. The client can email it to themselves, can zoom it in, zoom it out. So that's the new way, new technology.
If I don't live in a big city, how can I become a model? So if I live in Alabama, Tennessee, how can I become a model?
You need to travel. Sorry, lady. You need to travel. It's very important. Major cities, New York, California, Miami, Chicago is booming a little as well. So you just gotta travel. There's a lot of models that travel from all parts of the world. If you don't have it for a hotel room, let me tell you what models do. Besides driving or taking the bus or something cheaper, they would totally come to New York on a one day. So they would buy one ticket, come in at 7 o'clock in the morning, go to casting at 12, and then get back on a plane at 9 p.m. and just stay at the hotel, nap and sleep until their next flight. So you don't have to pay for a hotel, you're just paying a round trip ticket. I know it's a lot, but it's following a dream. Just like doctors, they pay a lot for school to become a doctor, lawyers. It is just an occupation that you have to invest money to get money in return.
Hi from Jessica Milagros.
Hi, Jessica Milagros. Jessica Milagros is a prime example, ladies. She travels. I'm not going to say where she travels from because I don't want you to give any stalkers. But she travels every single week, numerous times, just to get here to gigs. So she is a person that does not live in a major city, but she makes it happen. And you would think she lives in a major city. So you just got to push yourself.
Do I have to have my social media public in order for me to get seen?
Yes, absolutely. You cannot be a public figure and living a private social media life. You have to be public. If you enter a contest, guess what? They don't see you when you're private. And also, what are you hiding from? So you gotta clean up your Facebook, clean up your social media handles, clean up your Instagram, and be out there and be more sociable. Another thing, you have to have your full name. So my name is Model Christina Mendez or Christina Mendez on Facebook. If you are Sweetcakes55, it's not gonna work, okay? Clients are not gonna find Sweetcakes55. I remember her as Lisa, but I think she's Sweetcake55. That's not gonna happen. So stay with your government name, whatever name you use, please have that as your social media page.
If I have a picture wearing Ashley Stewart, should I tag everyone and their mother so everyone can notice me?
You just have to tag Ashley Stewart and they will absolutely notice you. So hashtag Ashley Stewart, hashtag buy Ashley Stewart, hashtag finding Ashley Stewart, hashtag go crazy, AS, anything. And also tag Ashley Stewart, which is important. So anyone that goes into Ashley Stewart's page can actually see it if they click on the right side, tags and stuff. So you gotta do it all. And yes, just go buck wild. And I do more than one picture. Like, don't just do one picture. Facebook?
They're saying, what do you mean by a clean social media?
A clean social media means clean. Like, not what you did yesterday night, not like a shot of the Coronas in your living room. Like, not that. A clean meaning a professional Facebook, Instagram page. If you're into modeling, let it be model related. You posing, you wearing awesome stuff, you trying on new makeup, you trying on new shoes. Like, I even, my kids are in a private page where I have. So even my family, I try to keep it separate. So when you come to my page, if you're a client, that's what you want to see. Yes, my kids are absolutely adorable, but I don't think every client be like, oh, I'm going through, oh, kids, oh, she's so cute, and forget why they're there. Let them know, like, okay, I came to your page to hire you, and I see a bunch of pictures that make me want to hire you right away. So that's what I mean by clean.
What about stage names?
No stage names. As a plus-size model, you shouldn't have a stage name. Well, you're in the wrong profession if you have a stage name. So keep the stage name Instagram on one side, and then keep your modeling one on the other side. Because I'm not going to, I mean, yeah, you could be a singer, but no.
So is it wise to have a professional page and a separate page?
Absolutely. I actually do. I have a Facebook page that's private. That's all my kids. It has my kids as the main picture. So you couldn't even find me unless you absolutely know my kids. And then I have one that's totally public where everyone can see, can hashtag and tag me on with no restrictions. So I do have two pages.
What sites should we go to find modeling gigs?
There's a couple of sites. I can give them to you, but you would have to come to my page so I can give them to you, because this is not my Instagram live.
Are home pictures posing okay?
Yeah, they are, but not for a comp card and not for a casting. So those should only be on your Instagram page, but they should always be clean. Like, as a model, lighting is key. If you would see how much lights I have right now, you would be like, it's too much. But I actually have this in my household. Lighting should be very important in your pictures. You should be looking like the same shade of color that you are. Your hair should be the same color that it should be. So when they see you in person, they'll be like, oh my God, I didn't even know your eyes were green, or I didn't even know you had blonde hair. So lighting is key. It doesn't matter if it's a house picture.
I know you're a freelance model. How do you feel about agencies?
It's for each its own, ladies. For each its own. I think freelance works for me because I'm a single mom. I have two kids. One of them is autistic. So it's very difficult for me to be at an agency's beck and call. As an agency model, you have to understand they're making money out of you. So when they need you to report somewhere, you have to be there. And as a freelance model, I don't have any restrictions. I control my own schedule. So it just works for me.
Keep the questions coming in.
So Instagram is rocking. Facebook, you guys are slacking. And YouTube, I don't know. How do you even look at YouTube live? I don't know. My first time on YouTube live.
Oh, this is a good question. Do you have to work twice as hard as a freelance model?
Yes, you absolutely do. I have to keep up with the Joneses, basically. I don't know what's going on. You know, I don't have anyone in the industry as an agent to tell me, like, girl, you know, we just changed our books. We're going to ditch off books and do iPads. We're going to move our comp cards from little to huge. Like, those were things that I learned after it happened because I don't have an agent. So as I was at castings and I would see that and I was like, dude, you don't have a book anymore? And, you know, models offer some information for free and sometimes they don't. The same thing with a comp card. I went into an office and there was a big comp card. I was like, God, that looks nice. And then I saw two and then I saw three and then I was like, there we go. So as a freelance model, you have to be very observant. You have to be very, keep your ears and eyes on the streets because you do have to work harder to keep up with them.
What could we do to model for Ashley Stewart? We've covered that, but maybe you can talk again.
Again, we have covered that. We've been on for a while. But to model for Ashley Stewart, you can do a million other things. You can do a million things. One of them being you can go and find an agent. They do work with major agencies to look for their models. Two, you can get discovered on social media by posting your awesome pictures with your awesome Ashley Stewart looks and hashtagging and tagging them. You can go to networking events like Full Figure Fashion Week and by actually going to events like they're opening in April. Yes. And then the last one is entering model contests. They have a model contest going on, Finding Ashley Stewart 2017. Next stop, Houston, Texas, then Detroit, then Jersey, then New York.
We're all over.
All over, so go and check them out.
What app do you use for billing?
Billing, I use, I'm not gonna tell you that as well. No, come to my page. I don't want to promote everything on By Ashley Stewart because this is all about By Ashley Stewart and how to get with them. But come to my modeling workshops every Tuesday and Thursdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, and I give out a bunch of information, including that one. So no, I'm not hiding it from you. I'm just not giving it to you on this session.
Okay, they're still asking about freelance modeling. So how do you keep up? What can they do to get gigs?
Again, all on my Instagram, I give you all the sites. There are paid sites that you pay monthly, and you have the same access as some agents to actually enter yourself in the drawing, submit your pictures, submit your information, and get casting. So there's absolutely, absolutely options on getting gigs as a freelance model without needing an agent. But again, networking, social media, and model contests are key for a freelance model to get started. You could totally rock it.
So they're asking again for your social media channel so they can follow you and get more details.
That is Model Christina Mendez on all, or you can just go to www.christinamendez.com and it has a link to all of my social media. You can put it there and tag it, whatever.
Yeah, we already did on Facebook.
So if you go on Facebook, this is recorded, so go to my Facebook. And Facebook, where are you guys? Where's Facebook?
They're saying, I can't wait until Finding Ashley comes to New Jersey.
Yay.
Let's see what else they're saying here. Is 38 too late to get started?
No, it's not. Again, there's not a real age limit for modeling. You just got to take care of yourself and just follow your dreams.
Let's see. Keep the questions coming, ladies. Are your live videos recorded? Yes. Go to Facebook and you'll see our live video as soon as we're done. Instagram, unfortunately, is not recorded. So make sure to visit Ashley Stewart at By Ashley Stewart on Facebook so you can check out the whole conversation. Is Finding Ashley coming to Chicago?
They're not, but they're coming to Detroit. And Detroit and Chicago, come on, you can make it, totally. So they're coming to Detroit, not Chicago.
Okay, so should you wear makeup on model calls?
You should wear light makeup. You shouldn't wear red lipstick, black lipstick, pink lipstick. You should be the natural enhance you, if that makes any sense. So if you're gonna do smoky, do a brown smoky. If you're gonna do contour, try to be a glowy contour. So something where it's not too dramatic that they have to think, what does this woman look like without makeup? So again, light makeup, definitely blush, definitely, you know, some mascara, not super cloy eyelashes, not crazy defined eyebrows, so just a cute. So if you go to a MAC store, say I want a natural glow, don't know what that is.
What do you do to stay snatched?
I do a lot of cardio. Again, I'm a single mom, so I do a lot of running around, unnecessary. But necessary sometimes. So I do a lot of cardio. I love to run. I love the elliptical and I definitely love the treadmill. I'm not a weight girl, I'm not into that.
Okay, they're asking for the Finding Ashley Stewart stops. So to answer
Detroit,
that.
I mean, right. Houston is next.
Right.
Then Jersey,
mm-hmm.
Then Detroit, then the last stop, New York.
Yep, and we might be doing some surprise stops. So go to Finding Ashley. You can find that information at www.ashleystewart.com.
Perfect.
And there you'll find dates, locations, all the details you'll need.
And follow Ashley. Well, obviously you guys probably already following, but follow them and they give out information all the time.
Since you are freelance, where did you get your comp cards done at?
Come back to my page. Again, my Model 101 Instagram Lives are Tuesdays and Thursdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, and I'll give you guys all that information. Again, it's a lot of information to give in this just one session, but this is Ashley Stewart just helping you guys, tell you guys that, hey, they care, they want you to fulfill your dreams, and they're here to help. So this right here was a little sample of what I have on my page, so you guys can fulfill your dreams and be Ashley girls.
What inspired you to do modeling?
I used to always model when I was in high school, but I didn't think back then there was no plus size girls. They were all skinny, skinny girls. They looked like Barbies, and I never thought I was good enough for it, but I just enjoyed runway. I went to college, had a son, pretty young, I had a son, and he was diagnosed with autism when he was 2 years old. I'm trying to rush through the story. And it was very difficult for me. So I used modeling as an outlet to kind of rediscover myself, to get back in the game. He didn't speak till he was 7. So that was really hard, trying, depressing, stressful time in my life. And when he actually started to speak, I said I wanted to do something for myself. And I chose to do something that I've always wanted to do, because then it started to boom a little back then. So, you know, I just used him as an inspiration, and that's how I started modeling. I was trying to speed that story up.
What's your greatest achievement as a model?
Every gig to me is a greatest achievement. Again, I started late. I started with a child. So I always had those same things that you guys are saying. Am I too short? Am I too old? I had all those, just those issues within me. So I think that every gig that I get is an accomplishment to me, because for a long time, I didn't think that I could do it. Just like you guys are sitting here looking at me like, but I'm too old, but I'm too short, but I got kids, but I don't got no money. That's exactly all the things that I question myself with. So my greatest accomplishment is every single gig I get means a thousand times to me, because for a long time I didn't think I could do it.
How do you pick a photographer, and how do you build a portfolio?
Picking a photographer is key, is very important. You've just gotta, it's just like any person you're gonna hire to do your plumbing, to do your carpeting. You're gonna research it, you're gonna ask questions, you're gonna say, can I see other pictures you've done? And just speak to this person. You gotta be totally comfortable when you're in front of a camera. So if the photographer is creeping you out, then maybe that's not the person you need to shoot with, because it's gonna show in your face like.
What about wearing jewelry to castings and modeling in general?
It's preferred to be without jewelry, because it's all about you. You're not selling like an awesome neck piece, but it depends on the casting. Ashley Stewart, and finding Ashley Stewart, being that a model search, they want you to show your personality. So if you have an awesome neck piece, then go for it. But not all castings are like that. So if you're in doubt, just go with nothing and just be awesome you.
How much should you pay for a photographer?
It could range. I would say a good price would be like $200 per look. They usually do packages like 3 to 4 looks, and that should be around $3 to $5. Anything over that, you know, it just depends on their skill set. They might be really skillful and they might charge a lot. So just fact find, see what they've shot before, see other models. Contact them through social media and say, hey, Christina, I saw you shot with Lisa, whatever. Is she good? Would you recommend her? And see how it goes.
Okay. What do you feel, how do you go about taking pictures or saying no to clients when you're not comfortable in a piece?
You can't. If you're getting paid to model, it's not your option. I know I've modeled moos for like a good 70% of my careers. Moos, grays, blacks, dark blues, things that you're on in grandma. Like recently I'm doing this kind of stuff. Back then it was nothing. I used to model muumus and for my Spanish people, huge baticas, like just batas, like just straight gowns, okay? So unfortunately when there's a check involved and when you have accepted a job, you just gotta go with the punches, okay? And you have to say nothing. And there's things that you can be like, I would never wear this in the street, but you say nothing, ladies, because a designer, their design piece is their baby. So you're saying like, oh, I don't like this. That person could have like slept sleepless nights trying to create this dress for you. So unfortunately, you just gotta go with it. And it is what it is. I've wore a lot of stuff that I'd be like, God, I hope no one is in the audience to see it. And it's not.
So should you be prepared for gigs? So for instance, if you know you're gonna go shoot for jeans and all of a sudden they tell you to wear Dare to Bear and you're not ready, what do you do?
You should always be prepared. And for those who don't know what Dare to Bear is lingerie. So you should always have everything like prepared, okay? So ladies, high jeans and waxing and shaving should always be there, no matter if you're shooting boots. And then they'd be like, you know what, these boots, we wanted to put it with a bikini and then just the boots. You'd be like, oh, okay. So you just gotta always be prepared. You never know what you're shooting that day, and that's really important.
How much should we have in our portfolio to present to a potential employer?
You should have quality stuff. So if it's 3 quality pictures, it is better than 20 all right pictures. So at least 3 minimum, 10 maximum. You shouldn't put a bunch. I know portfolio books have a lot of sleeves. It was not meant for you to fill them up, if that makes any sense. My book is not filled up, purposely not filled up, and you don't have to fill yours up. And for those that are looking at me like, why is she like, I have Instagram, I have Facebook, and I have YouTube right now.
I'm a mom myself, and I would like to know what keeps you driven to focus your dreams and not deviate with everything that goes on in your daily life.
Oh my God, isn't that the hardest thing? It is very difficult, and I learn every day. I just gotta keep on trying. And then I just think about it. I have a daughter and I have a son. So I just think, how can I tell them to follow their dreams if I have not followed mine? So my inspiration to always be like, keep on trucking. And so when I sit down with them and have that talk, I could be like, your mom hustled and struggled to make this happen. I expect that much more of you. So it's just an inspiration to use as an example when we have the talk, girl. When we have that talk.
Did you go into modeling full time when you first started, or did you do it as a side job until you became successful?
I did it as a side job until I became successful, and yes, I had other gigs. And you just, to start with, you're going to be spending more money than you're going to make, because you need a new portfolio book, you need new pictures, you need hair and makeup, you need awesome hair, you need to go to the gym. These are all expenses. So sometimes you're going to have to get a side job that either gives you nights or gives you opportunity to work on the weekends or gives you a flexibility that when you don't have a casting, you can go to work or vice versa, because you're going to have to spend more money than you're going to make. And don't get discouraged, because you're gonna be like, oh my God, it's been a year and I have nothing in return. It's, for some people, it takes decades, and that is the sad truth.
Okay, who is your role model in the modeling industry?
In the modeling industry, I have so many. I don't wanna name one, because then I'll be like, why you didn't name her? I have so many. Anyone in the industry who